Everybody, TwinklePhoenix here. First of all, what you're about to watch is not like the best translation from Japanese to English at all. It's the best I can do. I did research a ton to find as much as I could to make sure the translation was best I could. And this is all for fun. I'm not making any money out of this in case somebody turns around and says I am. And it's created by Quin Rose. As you can see the name down there. That's who created the game, not me. And this person here owns all the rights and everything. I'm just showing you guys the gameplay, and if you guys want to play it yourselves, you can just go out and buy it. I bought mine, and it's a really good game. This is probably more for the girls will like, because in this game you play as a girl called Alice, and you end up in this strange world of your dreams, apparently, playing a game, and all of the other characters are falling in love with you, and you can actually get a route for each one of them. I'm gonna do some games like this as well because my channel is gonna be for everyone. I'm gonna make sure there's something for everyone, and even I enjoy playing these type of games. So this is, I'm gonna try to keep these episodes really small for you because it does take, there's quite a long opening, trust me. But this is the very first episode, and I do hope you enjoy. Be warned, some English subtitling kind of got a little bit muddled up, but this does have face cam as well. So yeah. Please do enjoy the very first episode, and again, check out Quin Rose's work. I'll put a link to the site, plus the game and the manga as well, because the manga's really good to read as well. They're really fun. Again, this is probably some more of the girls would watch. I translated this as best I could, did research. Luckily, there's a lovely blog as well you can go to double make sure that your English is correct. Ugh. I also had a grammar checker to make sure I spelled everything right, and I still am not happy with the English translating. Anyway, please do enjoy the very first episode. So, we're about to begin Alice in the Country of Hearts. The audio might not sync up very well, in case it doesn't, you know. Also, my face can be dark because we're doing this late in the afternoon. And yeah, let's just start.
Hey, do you know?
No, I don't know. What am I supposed to know? Why is it
The
ticking?
rules in every game, rules everyone has to obey. It's been decided from the very beginning.
Who decided it? Who are you talking about? What game?
You must participate in the game. That's also one of the rules. It's been decided from the beginning also.
Again, who
But of course, you already knew about all this, right?
No, I didn't. What are you talking about? Who are you?
Huh? You don't know. As long as you understand the explanation, you don't need to worry.
That's what he said.
See?
See what? I see a glowing light. Oh God, it's getting closer. What's happening?
Come, the game will
Oh,
start
hello.
soon.
Who are you? As I open my eyes, I'm surrounded by the usual scenery. Is that your house? A familiar garden with blooming flowers. A calm, beautiful day as usual. Oh, my head hurts. I'm in shock. Because of me suddenly waking up, my head got dizzy. Again, she lives in this house? Since when? Why, Alice, it's because you're taking naps outside again, right? Oh, God. Hello, Lorena. It's wonderful seeing you. Reading a book beside me, Lorraine, my eldest sister, was giggling. Again, are they living in a castle? I'm shocked by the house. So graceful. The house or your sister? Oh, your sister, right. They were talking about your house. With my head fully awake, that thought just popped up in the back of my mind. Come to think of it, my sister has always been beautiful. I don't think she's flashy and popular, but still, she's sparkling in my eyes. Her laughing voice is just like a flower. Maybe I'm just extradite things, but that's what I really think. Laughing like a flower. Must be right from Alice in Wonderland. Compared to me, it's totally different. Yeah, because you're younger than her, isn't it? Maybe this is what people say attached between sisters. No, I don't get that. You're an adult now. You need to be more elegant. What's her definition of elegant?
My gentle sister is so modest. She's taking the role as a mother, too, because of our busy parents.
Aww.
With no intention to resist, I'm usually replying yes to her.
That's kind of worrying.
I wonder if someday I will turn to be a lady like her.
Do you want to be a lady like her?
Nah, it's too impossible. With my form spending much of my own time snoring in the garden, becoming a lady like Lorena, it's still far away.
But you don't know that? Could be very close for all you know, Alice.
While lying down sloppily, I'm looking up to my sister. I'm getting used to it.
What part are you getting used to?
I'm happy being with her. I love to admire pretty things. They honestly don't get much prettier than my sister.
Yes, apparently. First of all, guys, I am sorry if you do hear some men. Nobody gives a shit in this house about my feelings or not.
I love Sunday. Even though I need to wake up in the morning for going to church, I love to spend time in this warm afternoon.
I'm going to church. That's a good thing, I think. Possibly, of course it is. I just don't go to church normally on Sundays. People just stay in and sleep.
Somehow, I got a weird dream.
Weird dream? How so?
Lying around as I speak, I'm hoping to make this moment more enjoyable.
A dream? What kind of dream? Very good question, Lorena. What kind of dream?
What kind? I don't think it's a lovely dream like this garden, for example. It's more to be a dark dream with painful feelings inside.
That's not a good dream. It's a nightmare.
It seems deep and gloomy everywhere. I feel like falling down. And even though it's only a dream, I got a feeling I can't go back. But it's not a nightmare.
Still,
that's the curious part.
I was saying, it was still enough to make me worry about you, Alice. It's not a nightmare.
Even if I know I can't go back, I don't feel hopeless, nor scared, but a relief. Gloomy, but not painful. Instead, it's a very peaceful dream.
Okay, then.
I don't remember the details.
Fair enough, then.
About the game and its rules. Game? Alice, you want to play games? I see. I'm sorry, I was reading a book all this time, so I didn't realize it.
That's alright.
Huh? It's not that at all. Please don't worry about it, sister. Recently, my sister's boyfriend has become a novelist, so now she's polishing her reading skills. It's not bad to be a bookworm. I'm not a child who will get angry when nobody cares, and I don't want to intrude to interrupt my sister while she's reading, too. Much less, I don't want to see my sister getting sad.
Fair enough.
Not at all. A dream is an expression of one's wish. Recently, I read about it in a psychology book.
Oh, God. You're really intelligent, you are. You're extremely intelligent, Lorena.
If I'm not mistaken, it is a Freud dream theory, right? The meaning in a dream always affects with that person's desire.
Well then, you learn something new every day.
Of course, I can't say that every dream has it. But there are many dreams influenced with wishes. With wishes, though.
Had enough?
With wish salt.
Whoa, sister, you're well informed.
Ever since she's bloody at the book.
Looks like she hasn't, though.
I don't know how to react. I don't know this fruit at all. You shouldn't say admire, you should say admit.
I point that out as I was voicing it over.
My sister is amazing. She's kind and clever, and she's in love, too. She has everything I don't have. But it's so different.
How's it so different? Your sisters. You just said
because
you were.
My ideal concept of a woman is always besides me. I never worry about my own ladiness. It's not that my sisters trained me wrong, but I don't have the spirit to compete at all. Hey, what book are you reading now? Is it that psychological book? Oh, this book? You could say that.
I could say that. Oh, okay.
It's a novel, but it's similar to a fairy tale.
A fairy tale?
Fairy tale?
Exactly. That's a good thing to read. Always read fairy tales. Fairy tales
are
awesome.
Mouth wide. But don't look down at it. Even a fairy tale novel is intended for children. Usually have a moral of life lesson besides the story.
True. Well, I like that she was in depth with
it. I'm not looking down at it. I'm just surprised sister would read a fairy tale.
Well then, that was all for episode 1 for now, everybody. I will see you in episode 2. I'm sorry that the opening is extremely long. I'm so sorry for that. I really am. I have tried to shorten them down as best I can. So yeah, I'll see you in episode 2. Which will be up. I think I'll put this up like once a week, I think, depending. Anyway, I do hope you enjoyed. Bye bye. TwinklePhoenix signing off. Ta ta.